हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। आई होप यू आर मेकिंग नोट्स प्रॉपरली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ गिवन लेक्चर्स एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग द फैक्ट्स क्लियरली। इन माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर जस्ट यू हैव स्टडीड हाउ इंटीग्रेटेड रेट लॉ content for a first order reaction is derived, and before that just we have studied that is of integrated rate law for zero order reaction, that was also derived simply. So one more point in left, that is how first order reaction related to rate law is related with half life period. The objective of today's lecture is how the integrated rate law equation for first order is related with half life period. Just you have studied just before this lecture that how zero order reaction was related to half life period. So similarly here, first order reaction is how related with half life period, and you are knowing simply what is half life period or half life time. That is the time at which the concentration of the reactants become half of its initial concentration is called half life period and represented by T half. Okay, so just you have derived a first order rate constant, that is K is equals to 2.303 by T into log 10 concentration of R0 upon concentration of R, where R0 is the concentration of that is showing initial concentration and R showing final concentration of the reactant. Alright student, so this expression you have derived, okay, that was called integrated rate law for first order reaction, and that very reaction is called integrated rate law for first order reaction, in which K is a rate constant, T is the time, and these two are initial and final concentration of the reactants respectively. Alright, this expression can, or this is 2.303, this expression can also be written as children simply T is equals to 2.303 upon K into log at base 10, log at base 10 concentration of initial concentration divided by final concentration of the reactant. Okay, may be written. So we have to relate this expression with half life period. So children, in this, suppose this is equation 1, in this expression if we put in place of a small t writing t half, where T half showing half life period, that is HLP, and in place of this final concentration of the reactant R, write R0 by 2 according to the definition of half life period. Just you are defining half life period is that the time at which the concentration of the reactant become half of its initial. So R0 is initial, that is half of its initial concentration, that is R is equal to R0 by 2 will be the half of the initial concentration of that reactant. So in place of R, write R0 by 2, and in place of T, write T half. Then equation 1 will turn as, so put the values, in place of T, write T half, and that is 2.303 upon K into log of the 10 concentration, initial concentration, and this value, final concentration, write in place of R0 by 2. So that is R0 divided by 2, means R0 by half. Okay. So this fraction can be easily solved. You are knowing that very simply, 1 divided by 1 by 2. Then what is children? That is 1 into 2 by 1, and you are knowing. So simply, this can be written as 2.303 by k into log 10 and R0 by R0 or into 2. Into 2. Am I right, children? This fraction R0 by R0 by 2 can be changed into this form on the basis of this fraction, as you have already studied in class 1 or 2 or below that class. How 1 upon 1 by 2 is this one. Similarly, that is turned as. So this R0 and this is cancel out. This is cancel out. So what is left? So T half is equals to 2.303 by k into log 10 2. This is 2. And children, you are knowing the value of log 2 at base 10. And the value of log 2 at base 10 is 2.3010. So that becomes 2.303 by k into value of log 10 2 is what you have to remember, 0.3010. Okay, similarly value of log 10 3 is what, 0.4771. so you have to remember these values if not given in your answer book. So by multiplying these two, 2.303 into this one, the value is coming, that is 0.0693 by k, and that is equal to what? That is equal to 2 t half. So we are getting here expression, suppose equation number 2, which is showing the relationship between half life period and k for the first order reaction. And one more thing, children, in equation 2, it is very clear, it is very evident that half life period for first order reaction is completely independent of concentration, because there is no any concentration term is present in the expression 2. Am I right? Listen once again. From equation 2, it is clear that half-life period for first order reaction is completely independent with concentration of the reactant, means the half-life period for first order doesn't depend upon the concentration of the reactant, but that is inversely proportional to the rate constant. Okay, so must remember, on this basis you have to solve numericals which are given in your book. Let us get. So must remember formula that is showing the relationship. So question comes that how that integrated rate law for first order reaction is related with half lifetime. So you have to apply in this manner, and lastly this will show the relationship between T half and K. And this is clearly showing that is half-life period for first order reaction doesn't depend upon the concentration of the reactant, while in the case of zero order, that is completely depending upon the concentration of the reactant, and that was inversely proportional to the rate constant in the case of zero order. But here in the case of first order, the meaning is completely different. And it has been also taught that unit of this k first order reaction is what children per second, per minute, per time or per year according to the given question. So must remember unit for first order rate constant is per second, unit for zero order just it has been explained rate constant unit for zero order reaction is what, that is mole per liter per second. Am I right? Similarly, what is the unit for rate second order? This is zero order, first order, and for second order unit of rate constant is, that is liter, must remember, liter per mole and per second. Okay, so this is showing the unit for second order, this is for second order, this is for first order, that is for zero order, and the rate constant unit for third order reaction is given as, that is liter square mole to the power minus 2 per second. So children, often question comes that what is the unit of third order rate constant, what is the unit of first order constant? So remember units also. Okay, very important also. One mass question comes that write the unit of that order of reaction is. So you have, if you have learned, then you are in position to easily write the units of these all the four order rate constant reactions. Okay, one more point in this topic you have to study, that is also a very much importance, that is pseudo first order reaction. So what is pseudo first order reaction? This one, that is pseudo first order reaction. Often question comes that define pseudo first order reaction with a suitable example. So what it is? So listen sincerely student, the pseudo first order reaction can be defined as the reaction which is not truly of first order. Listen sincerely, how it can be defined? The pseudo first order reaction can be defined as the reaction which is not truly of first order, but under certain conditions it becomes of first order, is called pseudo first order reaction. For example children, you have heard the name of cane sugar. So inversion of cane sugar is a generally biomolecular reaction or bimolecular reaction, but under certain conditions it becomes a first order reaction because the concentration of water is quite large and that cannot be changed appreciably. That's why inversion of cane sugar is a pseudo first order reaction, but actually it is a bimolecular reaction. For example, C12H22O11, as you are knowing, it is a cane sugar or sucrose. Okay, on hydrolysis, under the presence of any acid, gets converted into glucose and fructose, that is C6H12O6. Suppose it is a glucose or maybe fructose. Okay, so in this children, this reaction, it looks like of bimolecular, but due to quite large concentration of this water here present in this reaction and that did not change appreciably, that's why this reaction is of pseudo first order and its rate can be given as K is equals to C12H22O11 that is rate is equal to k and that is power 1. So this is a pseudo first order reaction. Similarly, one more example you can put that hydrolysis of esters. You are knowing esters. So hydrolysis of esters is also actually a bimolecular reaction, but under certain conditions, or you can say due to the quite large concentration of water, that is a reason behind to show a pseudo first order reaction. For example, suppose I writing one ester compound and it is ester generally called ethyl ethanoate or ethyl acetate, C2H5 it is. IUPAC name ethyl ethanoate, simply called ethyl acetate. As you like, you can write plus water. Objective was similarly as a inversion of cane sugar, hydrolysis of ester is also a good example of pseudo first order reaction. You have to remember it. And under the presence of certain acids, that gets converted into an alcohol and a carboxylic acid, and this is converting into this one, in which this is ethanoic acid or acetic acid, this is ethanol or ethyl alcohol. Am I right? And this is ethyl acid. So in this example, children, also the concentration of this water is quite large and that cannot be changed appreciably. That's why, according to definition, under certain condition, a reaction is showing a first order, but actually it is not a first order. Actually, the reaction which is not a first order, but under certain condition that is showing first order, then in that condition, the reaction is said to be pseudo first order reaction, and the rate of this very reaction can be given as rate is k into the concentration of that is CH3COOC2H5. Okay, so this is showing the pseudo first order reaction. You have to remember it, children. Why this is pseudo? What is difference? Why it is converting? So clear cut definition, you are knowing that a reaction which is truly a not a first order reaction, but under certain condition the reaction become a first order, then that reaction is termed pseudo first order reaction. And the good examples of pseudo first order reactions are written. Any of you can explain it. So must remember what is pseudo, why it is converting into a pseudo first order. So these points you have to remember it. And in next part of the lecture or in my upcoming video lecture, you will study one more important point, children, that is dependence of rate constant with temperature, and that is termed Arrhenius equation. Arrhenius equation. This is also very much important point of this very topic. Means how we can explain dependence of temperature with rate constant, and that was given by a Swedish chemist, namely Arrhenius, and on his name the equation is termed Arrhenius equation, that is showing a relationship between temperature and rate constant. Let us hear. So we will, our next objective will be this one. So till then, I remember all the points which I have taught today, and in next lecture we will study Arrhenius equation related to chemical kinetics. Okay, student, thank you for joining us. Be sincere.